Hello everyone, my name is Wei, and today I will be presenting on the topic of stock options contract, specifically the price of call options. Please check out our other videos to get the basics of options contract. And without further ado, here is price of call option. Here is the quick review on call options contract. You have stock XYZ currently trading at some price per share. You go to the options market for stock XYZ and buy a call option with specific strike and expiration date. By exercising a call contract, you get to buy the stock at the strike specified on the contract. Now, each call options contract with a different strike and different expiration date has a different price associated with it. But what is this price made of? To find that out, we need to understand the intrinsic value and the extrinsic value of call options contract, because the price you pay for the contract is the sum of intrinsic value and extrinsic value. Let's first look at the intrinsic value through an example. We have stock XYZ currently trading at $100 per share. We want to buy a call contract, so we look at the option chain for stock XYZ. Options chain is just a table that shows all available contracts for the stock. In this example, we have strikes 80 to 120 with $10 increments available to us in the option chain. Notice different colors highlighting the strikes. Every strike below the current stock price is in the money, abbreviated by ITM. The strikes that matches the current stock price is at the money, abbreviated with ATM. And strikes above the current stock price is out of the money, abbreviated by OTM. Only in the money strikes have intrinsic value, because if you own in the money contracts, you can buy shares at a lower price than the current stock price. Let's look at the strike 80. If we own this contract, we can exercise it to buy the shares at $80 per share, even though the current market price for the stock is $100 per share. If we sell the shares right back to the market, there is an instant $20 gain per share. Therefore, this contract has intrinsic value of $20 per share. Let's look at another one, strike 90. If we own this contract, we can exercise the contract to buy the shares at $90 per share and sell it right back to the market for $100 per share and have an instant gain of $10 per share. Therefore, the intrinsic value is $10 per share. So if you can buy the contract below its intrinsic value, you have risk-free gain by exercising the contract to buy the shares and then sell the shares right back to the market. This process is called arbitrage. Okay, let's move on and take a look at strike 100. If we own this contract, we can exercise to buy the shares at $100 per share. If we sell it right back to the market for $100 per share, there is no gain. Therefore, this contract has zero intrinsic value. And anything above 100 makes no sense to exercise, because why would you choose to buy shares above the current market price? Therefore, all strikes above the current stock price has zero intrinsic value. With this, we can write the equation for intrinsic value of call options contract, and that is intrinsic value equals to stock price minus strike price for in-the-money strikes. Now that we covered intrinsic value of call options contract, let's look at the extrinsic value of call options contract. Let's bring back the table we filled out for intrinsic value. Let's say we look at the option chain and the price listed for the options contract is as follows. If we take away intrinsic value from the contract price, we are left with the extrinsic value. Remember, contract price is composed of intrinsic value and extrinsic value. So for strike 80, the contract price is 23, but we know the intrinsic value is 20. We subtract 20 from 23 and the remaining $3 is the extrinsic value. For strike 90, the contract price is 12, but we know the intrinsic value is 10. So we subtract 10 from 12 and the extrinsic value is $2. And for strikes 100, 110, and 120, We know there are no intrinsic value associated with at-the-money and out-of-the-money strikes. The contract price is the extrinsic value. So we have extrinsic value of $1 for strike 100, 50 cents for 110, and a quarter for strike 120. And with this, we can write the equation for the extrinsic value, which is extrinsic value equals to contract price minus intrinsic value. Now, how is this extrinsic value determined? This extrinsic value can be approximated using Black-Scholes pricing model. Luckily for us, we do not need to calculate this every time when we want to buy a call option, because the market generally provides fair market value, especially on stocks with high liquidity. Let's quickly review the equations we've covered in the presentation. We have contract price is the sum of the intrinsic value and the extrinsic value. And the intrinsic value is the current stock price minus the strike price. Note that only in-the-money strikes have intrinsic value. Extrinsic value is the contract price minus the intrinsic value. It is basically rearranged from the very first equation. In the next video, I will talk about how can value investors take advantage of buying call options. Thank you so much for watching. In this channel, we present on investment topics with plenty of examples. We cover investment terminologies, value investing, speculative investing, investment mathematics, and investment tools. Share, thumbs up, and subscribe if you like the video.